Hey guys.
So, got some cabinet or end table we're gonna be building. So this runs about $70 on Amazon, and I'll link it in the description below if you guys want to check it out. Pieces here. Okay, this one should be fun. Let's see if you guys got a decent view here of what we got going on. All right. So make sure you got plenty of room to lay this stuff out. Throw everything back in the box here. Here, these are pretty easy to work with. Nightstand again, multi-tool there. Okay, we don't need any instructions, do we? Come on. All right, so we'll just stick these in here like this. And then tie, let's see, screwdriver out. Grabs onto the other little piece there. Okay, so when you put these in, there's a little round area, and that little round area dot on there goes towards the hole there. So push those in. Not even sure why these weren't already pushed in, you know, it'd be a little easier, but that's all right. Pretty much anywhere we see those on the rest of this, I'm just gonna assume that we're just going to push it down in the hole and call it good. Go. These are really easy to work with. They're super handy little things. Just make sure when you push them in that the screwdriver head part is towards you, top. So you push them in there. You don't want this. You want to make sure that the little triangle, or the, not triangle, but the little cross is there, so you can get your Phillips head screwdriver in there and tighten them down. Yeah, it just saved me some time if they wanted to put these in there already. Okay, got those. Yes, this one's got some as well. Yeah, it does. Okay, here we go. Now on a mission here. There's that. There's that. There's that. Speed run this is going to be here. So we got a ton of these. Go, and the last one is right there. Okay, so those are all in. And then, if I'm not mistaken, these, and these just screw into those holes. I believe that's what we're going to do. So we got some, I'm going to take some of these pegs. I'm just going to guess where these go. Should turn out all right. Just not in the holes that take these. So the ones that don't have your little part there. Just stick these little pegs in there. If I'm not wrong, I think that's what we're gonna do. So I'm just gonna do it. And if I'm wrong, then I'll change it. Who needs instructions? I used to build Legos for days. All right. Okay. got four more of these and one where they're gonna go. Two, so these are all the same length, yes? Yes. All right, so these guys right here. Maybe I might have to dabble into the instructions. Shouldn't be that difficult to figure out. So we got these little things here. Okay, those are towards the... Those are going towards the front. And here's the back. Okay. So it looks like, if I'm not mistaken, these are just little screws here. Let's go with that. Four screws. Four. It's gotta be right. Okay, so I think these ones labeled D and F. Make our little drawer here, I guess. D. Okay, so it says when you screw them in, screw them flush to the shoulder. Shoulder is above the panel. Cam locks. And we want to screw. Step one is 5 and 6. Five, four, 3, 4, 5, 6. Basically, we're just going to put all these in there. These have three, so we're going to do that. Screw these down. I'm gonna make sure the little part goes up. This little collar here goes all the way down. Flush the wood there. Perhaps a drill might do me pretty good here, but we're just going to go hand tools only. Got this little multi-tool is pretty legit here, so I'm just going to use this. And it's just going to take a little while. Make sure you get these in there kind of straight. Oh, come on, Marcella. There's one. So it's gonna take a while here. so much for our speed run, but we might still still be getting a record here for a build. So usually these aren't too difficult to put together, or anything really for that matter. I think that building with Lego sets gives you a nice firm foundation for being able to follow instructions and stuff like that. So, especially things like these, if you can build some Lego sets, then these are pretty much child's play compared to the amount of pieces you have, like a Lego set or something. So, please want to be careful not to over tighten, because this is just kind of like a press board material here. So. Okay, there's two down. My goodness, it's going to take a while. So if you do have even just a regular screwdriver might be a little faster than this one, but kind of like this multi-tool I got. I do a lot of... screwdriver, like flathead, and different size flatheads, and hexagon level heads, and stuff like that. So, now we're cooking. There we go. That was a record speed on that one. Bad strategy holding the finger there and then
there we go.
Okay, that last one. I'm getting the hang of it now. You're rolling. Okay, here we go. Last one here for these. Okay, those ones are all done. So, insert the wooden thing into there. Wooden pegs into this one, number 7. So, number 7. That's not number 7. Dowel and cam locks in the other ones. We have 7 and 8 are the here. And then these ones go on there, I believe. Well, let's just make sure. So 8s here and 7s here. 7, 8, 3 and 4 go on to 7. So here's 4. Here's 5. Here's 6. And here is 3. So 3 and 4 go on 7. You got to make sure this is situated the correct way. And it's hard to say because we have additional things here, but it's not showing us. That's awesome. Yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna guess. Guessing. The top's gonna go up here, so these extra ones go up that way. So we have these two, these four there. So I'm guessing that those will go there. And then we're gonna have, what's this one? 3. This is what I think. That this is the top, but this would have to go like this. So, okay, so these ones are going to be that. So it can't be the other way, because then if this is the top, these can't be sticking up. So we have to situate it just like that. Have our little dowels there. There's two little dowels on both sides. Something like that. Okay. That looks a lot better, I think. There's little screws here and there. Does that look good? I mean, looks like what we're supposed to be dealing with there. If not, let's change it, right? So we just rotate these around. They grab the screw there. Just kind of firmly turn this around. Just like that. I don't want to over tighten. Just enough so that that holds it on there firmly. Okay, so those are on there. That, I believe. Gosh, I don't know. That's. Pay attention to the panels. Okay. So. Liking that. Insert wooden dowel, candle length, left side, rotate, lock in. Pay attention. 4. Okay, these instructions are bogus. I'm just going to come out and say. It might be, this is 7, doesn't show me where the things are, but it can't be here because that's where the top is going to go, alright? Top's going to go on there, so it can't be like that because this is going to go on the top of that. Okay, so, but if we do this like this, now we have this one right here, this line right here. Yeah, that's not gonna fly, I don't think. So oh, ends of left side panel 7 and right side panel 8, and near the creep of the holes of the gliders at the top and get into the ends of the legs. Okay, yes, top end, I see that. The little holes there for the glider. Bottom end for the legs, I'm seeing that, okay. I'm paying attention, but switch these, that'll work. Alright, so at least these are easy to undo. You can simply rotate those the opposite direction. So something's off here a little bit, guys. The instructions are not exactly telling me the truth here. Okay, so here we go. It's like that. These dowels go in there. Yes, yes, yes. Everything was good until it wasn't. So in order to undo these, just that little round circle part, make sure that's pointed towards the outside. So on the instructions, it's telling me this is the opposite direction. So the instructions were correct. So I was just looking at it wrong. My bad. It just felt like it was weird that this was not being placed like flat on the ground. You know, that was up a little bit. So that's the thing. So when these are snug enough, these the circle is just 90 degrees pointing in the opposite direction of where it was. So that's where we go. Tighten, just turn to that little spot there, and here we go. Okay. Ran into a little bit of a snafu there, and we're back on track to get this thing done here. So that's that, and now I should be able to rock this one pretty easily. So same thing here, top part. Lift it up a little bit. I believe 6, 7. I know this says, okay, 4, 5. All right, it's 6. It's this way. Okay, so once again, this is going up a little bit. This one, we have that side, okay. Okay, just like that, rotate this so it's 90 degrees, pulls it in snugly. So pay attention to the instructions there. I didn't. Okay. business here. Okay, 7, 8, and attach cam bolt A. Those doesn't have the little duty buffers on them, so I'm guessing the ones this is up, so these will go, I believe, this is the back part, and so the top drawer comes in the top, like the drawer comes in like this way. Yes. So, even though these aren't labeled, this one has to be out that way. Roll on this. So it has to be these two together and these two together. So then you can surmise. F4. Guessing that these little tiny flat screws here. I'm going to use four of these and then four of that one. So we'll see if my screwdriver bit is good enough. Good enough for that one. Okay, and where do we put them in? It's looking like center hole. Center. Okay, it says it's that one, but the picture's showing me it's going to be like this. I'm just going to go with the instructions, okay? Don't fault me for that. This is what the instructions say, even though it looks like it's going to be off. So the worst that can happen is I screw this in, and then I got to just change everything. So at least they're screws and not nails, so if I mess it up, I can just unscrew it. But it doesn't. This is the correct piece and everything. It just looks like the location is a little bit off according to the instructions. So just tighten that in a little bit, not over tighten. Okay. It just looks a little off to me as far as the instructions show this right here. And that's not what it's looking like right here. So but it says to do the screw right behind the first hole behind the wheel there. So that's what we're going to do until we know otherwise. Just act like we know what we're doing here. Some of these and they got some weird instructions and really hard to tell, you know, how you're working. So that's why I like to make a video. You guys could watch me make all the mistakes so you don't have to. Okay. That's that. Now we're going to need the bottom panel, which is not that one. It's the back panel. This is the bottom one, which is 9. Yes, verified. Okay. And two tens that go on there. And a 10. Two tens. Okay, this is a 10. It's got a 2 on there. Okay, fine. The 10 is telling me to put the screw in there. It was showing like 2 of them on the instructions, but it's kind of weird the instructions are. Oh, come on. How can I balance the end of a screwdriver? You know, it's not even possible. You know, do it. Okay, so this one's going to go if I'm not mistaken. Go right like that on here. Okay. Okay, so there it is there. Next is we attach bottom panel to right panel. Okay, so there we go. We put in our little wooden dowels right here. And we're going to attach the bottom panel here. So this should go something like that. Okay. And then we just grab this. That's the next step. Put that on there. This lead. Make sure that actually goes into the hole and not just underneath the board. Alright, so what's going on here? I'm just going to tip it over. As you can see. Make sure if it's not going in, again, we rotate it so the hole is facing that direction, that little round spot. Okay, align and verify. Please turn that. Okay, now we're cooking. Starting to look like an actual deal here. And now attach the bottom panel. Just did those tape number 11 here. I'm not sure exactly if it matters which side goes in there. And we just slide it down. Back here. Slide down in there. Then it does go into that. Hold there, just run your finger along there. Okay, so just like that. Now, Echo is 2. Yes, and these are going in those holes right there. I think that's probably a fairly good guess. Oh, fiddle battle. That's not good. Gotta be careful. These things are kind of delicate. This is the bottom. Okay. Now I think we're ready to put this on. If I'm not mistaken. Oops. I think actually
I have this here too though.
Screwed on there with E2, so that'll be our little front thing, I guess. Bag E2 in there. That one a little bit of the way, and then get this one going. Sometimes if you've got two different ones, you don't want to do one really tight in case it all's not gonna fit yet. So then you just kind of go back and forth and tighten them down and make it better. Okay, once again, don't over tighten. This isn't real wood, so you can strip it pretty easy.
Okay,
putting this in. You here for you guys. Alright. Okay, so now I have these four things to line up. Drop those in the holes. And also our little back piece as well. Gotta make sure that gets into this slot back. It's not rotated. Yes, this one. Yeah, both my back screw things floors. Make sure your little circle on these is pointed toward the hole. That way the screws will go in there. Okay. All right. Reassess. Double check. Here we go. Okay, it's in there, solid, like a rock. Take off that little sticker there. Maybe. Sticker doesn't come off. Oh, what the fiddly D, man. Goo gone for that bad boy. Okay. That is mostly done. Now, just need a little break. This is not sponsored by Mountain Dew, I wish it was. Right slider, new right slider, okay. Side. Okay, where are the big holes? So these little screws here again. Oh, crap. Tiniest screws. Baby screw. Oh, there it is, right on the black line, of course. That was classic. Okay, so the little arrow point part goes towards the back. These ones are actually lining up pretty good here, so we're just going to put it in the first hole. Thank you. this looks like it's the first and the last holes there. Okay, remember, don't over tighten. This point it's kind of nice to use a hand tool, so like the impact driver, you can feel how much resistance is there, and you don't want to tighten it too much. Okay, same thing with this one. It's the first and last one in the pre-drilled hole there. Here your screws going relatively straight. Golden. Get that one about halfway. Maybe go to the other one. So obviously four are going to screw into here, just like that. Has to go like that, so do that little number. Okay, so this one's just going to be careful. Tighten or anything. And then this one just goes like that. Okay. Just make sure your grooves line up there. And the holes there. And just like the last one, just kind of tighten it down. Has a lock in place. A little bit better, but as far as just kind of being too handy, that tool here is legit. There we go. And a little bit. Okay. The door is almost finished here. couple more of these to put in. Guys, not sure what the record built on this is, but I'm pretty sure we didn't get it. But I hope through the trials and errors that this was useful for you guys. Self-explanatory is where the easiest way would just bring all these, just get all these in, and then finished off. Got a little bit of hardware to put on this one. This one, make sure you get your little bottom part in there and slide that in there first. Just like that. So make sure it goes in the slot there. Make sure all our things are pointed up. Looks like that little felt things for the legs, and then I am not sure what that is, but we'll have to look at the instructions, I guess. Bottom drawer panel assembly. It doesn't say anything really about foot pad hole sticker. So this has little round parts, so if you want, you can cover these up. I don't even think that's necessary. Most of the stuff is on the inside. We can do it. Let's see how the drawer goes in here, though. Thank you. do little felt pads there. Where's my knife? Sorry, it's a little stuff separated from there. Separate. There we go. Be kind of persuasive with a knife. You have to be. Here's another one. Okay, my friends, I didn't get all the stickers off yet. Do a little tour here. And see, wow, 1 hour and 10 minutes. Are you kidding me right now? That was not a speed run, my friends. Okay, here we go. So if your drawer doesn't close, the little screws on the part. So just tighten these guys and make sure they're just kind of as flush as possible on here and here, and also on the ones in here too. You can kind of run your finger across it and see that. Okay, so that was what was holding the drawer up, so you run into that issue. It gave us those stickers over there too, so if you want to cover up all these little things with the stickers, you can. And yeah, things. And then to put in the drawer, these little wheels go on over those wheels first. So just get them up over the top. And then that just glides in there like that. So actually looks pretty nice. We'll get a little walk around here. Take the stickers off. Now that I know how to do it, I have a second one actually, and I'll probably knock it out pretty quick, probably in about half the time. I think the main part, if I probably use a different screwdriver that doesn't collapse like that, I'll be able to knock it out probably in half the time. And now that I know also how it was, the weird way the thing was threw me off there for a second. But yeah, looks pretty nice, decent size little drawer there. Nice little hardware, just kind of a simple little thing. Nothing super fancy, but looks pretty nice. Okay, my friends, well, thanks for watching this video. And you know what? I'm gonna go ahead and put these little stickers on there, I guess. We could do that, can't we? Sure, why not? We'll do it. Just let me lower my tripod here a little bit. And get those things on there. Pretty easy. Hopefully. Just try to get you guys a little better view there if I can. There we go. There we go. Okay, so for these, these are basically little just stickers that come off of there.
And then you can just place them right over the top of the thing there. You can't really tell, especially since it's kind of dark in there. These will cover that up nicely. So just like that. Not a bad little idea there. Hard to pop out of there. There we go. Come on, fella. Alright. Just like that. Okay, and we can cover all of them, but that's pretty much how it goes. That way you won't be able to see those little things there. So, okay guys, thanks for watching this video. I'll link these in the description below if you want to check them out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.